What type of talent they are losing, they are also monitoring that apart from what you just said, sir. And certain amount of attrition they don't really care about. So companies like GE, for example, they say that we would like to have attritions every year to a certain extent, and we would monitor people who are low performers and we would like to weed them out. So that's also happening to the contrary of what we just said. Yes, sir, you had a point.
There's one point I wanted to add, sorry, and that it's a different aspect of it. I mean, technology brings out the reasons, the patterns. Maybe you do a predictive analysis out of it. Abhijit sir brought another point to it on there's desired attrition and there's attrition which you don't want to have, right? So, and the third aspect is, and let me kind of prove it the other way around, and it's not my theory. How many of you are on LinkedIn? LinkedIn? Okay, there's quite a bit, right? How many on Facebook? Okay. How many on WhatsApp? Okay. Why are you on LinkedIn, WhatsApp, and Facebook?
Purpose is different.
Right, so there's expressing this and all. But the first and foremost reason you are on those things is because of the network there, right? So the network of friends, network of business professionals, network of mobile folks, friends, katta, right, as you call it in Marathi here. So that is the reason. So there was a myth before that people leave the manager. Okay. So there was a myth, and I mean, I'm calling it a myth now, but it is something which is assumed that people leave a manager. More and more research is coming out which says that the generation Z or Y, whatever YZ you are not leaving a manager or not leaving your supervisor, but you're leaving a network. So that's the level of engagement which is there with the network. So you're leaving a network. So attrition nowadays is being looked at from a network point of view and not particularly dependent on a person. Thank you. Yeah.
Sure. Thank you. Sir, you.
Well, sir, my question actually is not exactly related to the topic that was being discussed. But I would like to take the opportunity, since we have some of the top HR professionals from the industry present today. Most of us, all our students here, they are looking forward to great careers in the industry, and recently we have been hearing news about a lot of thrust being given by the government and our Prime Minister, Mr. Modi, for manufacturing base, to increase the manufacturing base, global manufacturing base. So that is likely to throw up lots of career opportunities and industry requirements. So our students would like to know, in what way do they need to prepare to meet those challenges from the industry? What are the kind of skills and maybe competencies that the industry is looking forward to? And how do they need to prepare? What kind of skills do they need to acquire? Can any of you throw light on this? Thanks a lot.
I would put the foremost this thing is keen sense of observation. You keep on observing things, you see a change, and then you understand what needs to be changed in yourself. So very keen, I just put this particular point, think about it.
One of the other things that I would like to talk about is, looking beyond your textbooks, because most of the things that you study today, there has to be a practical experience, somehow you need to get it. So do a lot of projects, do a lot of case studies which will help you to really go into areas beyond your textbook. I think that is very important, and obviously whenever we recruit, and sir you can also talk about it, and Sri Krishna, we will always recruit for the attitude and we'll train for skills. So you have the right attitude and have an attitude of going beyond your textbook, learning beyond whatever has been taught to you in the college, and I'm sure there'll be a lot of opportunities.
You know, this is a common question I hear. I teach in SPGN in Singapore and Dubai and Great Lakes in Chennai, and that's a question most often I hear, especially before a placement season. And one of the things common across geographies and business schools I do is beyond what, of course, I agree with these people, but, you know, sheer hard work. I think in today's generation, and I'm sort of obviously making a scathing remark here, is that the expectation about effort versus impact is all warped in our mind. That I want very less effort and maximum impact. That will not happen so soon. That will happen when I become a senior VP in Infosys and my salary goes 4 times overnight. But at your level, starting level, sheer hard work, nothing else, of course, going beyond books, not having to make expectations, that is there, but nothing beats hard work. That's my take.
I'm a marketer, so I will use the acronyms. I live by a principle which is called TDC. And when I hire any marketer, young marketers like you, I look for TDC. T stands for think, D stands for do, and C for communicate. A professional must do this. So you must not do first and think later. You must think, you must do, you must communicate. I need to ask you a couple of questions on this. This is actually my favorite topic. Subramaniam sir knows that. Let me ask you, you guys read newspapers? All of you? Cross your heart. Cross your heart. Yeah, I'm talking about newspaper. All right? Okay. Who is the CEO of a company called Wipro? Anybody? Thank you. Smell the coffee. Who is the CEO of Wipro, guy? Okay. I don't want to embarrass you guys, but if 200 people are sitting here and they don't know the CEO of Wipro, we need to smell the coffee. If I ask you, who is the boyfriend of Katrina Kaif, would you tell me that? You would. You would tell me, I'm sure, for sure. Which is the movie which has made the maximum money in the country? Tell me. One movie which has made the maximum money, 250 crores. Which movie? Bollywood. Huh? Chennai Express? Yeah, all of you know that, right? Did Hrithik Roshan separated from his wife or divorced? We all know that. Okay, let me ask you a simple one. Who is the CEO of Cognizant?
How young is he?
And which city he comes from? City where we are sitting in. He hails from city of Pune. He's a pride. Okay, Kaustubh is here, my friend. Who started Persistent? I mean, his jewel for Pune. Gentleman who started Persistent, he's a jewel. We take his name with a lot of pride. Come on, give me a break, guys. Prof, I've just answered your question. Guys, okay, yeah, sure. There you go. Can we give a round of applause to him at least? I know. No, okay. My job is not to embarrass. My job is not to make you feel bad about yourself. You guys are phenomenal people. You guys are very talented. That's one reason you guys are here. But information. First is seeking information and then processing it to make knowledge, which is useful to you. If you guys want to follow a career in Bollywood, you must read about Hrithik Roshan, Salman Khan's, their six packs, their false packs or whatever, right? All those things. But if you want to make a career in corporate, you should know about corporate. You guys know the CEO of Britannia? Parle? IDC? Come on. Okay. No. This is embarrassing for me. I'm asking 10 questions and you know, you guys don't know that. Okay. I will stop it here. I shouldn't go beyond because I will not be able to handle so many tears. Yeah? Yeah? No. The point is, again, smell the coffee. In not in the literal sense, it's a figurative English. You guys understand that. Smell the coffee means read the newspaper in the morning. Don't spend time in the night, 1 o'clock on Facebook and looking after your friend's girlfriend who went to Goa. Don't look at that. Look at what happened, ET. Look, read out what's happening in the world of business. What's happening? Which is the company which Cognizant has acquired? It is probably the biggest IT acquisition in the history. Sorry. And what was the value of the acquisition?
Sorry?
It's $2.5 billion, more than that, right? It's probably that. We need to know those things. We don't need to know necessarily the lives of Shah Rukh Khan's and the young ones also. Because if you want to follow a career in Bollywood, you want to write scripts, you want to write songs, then it's fine. But if you want to make a career in corporate, let's get to that direction. Yeah, so remember what? T, what stands for that?
Think.
Can I hear it again? TDC. Can I hear it again? Thank you very much.
So I'm just going to give 2 cents of it, okay? So HR, I'm not an HR guy, so that's why I'm going to add here, okay? So there's a book called What Got You Here Is Not Going to Get You There, okay? That's what it says, right? Yeah, Marshall Goldsmith, correct. So using the topic, right, and I don't want to get into the book so much, but it is going to get you here, right? It's going to land you a job. So that's what, if the question is, then it is answered. But beyond that, what I'm talking about or what kind of people you want to see in your team, innovation is far, far important. Think out of the box, think of new things. If the essentials are not right, you're not going to be able to do innovation and all. Innovation is making companies, breaking companies. Nokia is an example, IBM is an example. There's so many other examples which you'll see about companies. So innovation is a huge thing. And I just want to add one more part. Is I think you are at a cusp where you're seeing a lot of Indian companies, a lot of Indian product companies, a lot of companies who are doing so well being global MNCs. It's a huge chance for you to risk it all at this moment in time. So put it through. Get. Don't worry, you're not married. Tell your girlfriend that or boyfriends that hold on 4 or 5 years and then you'll get married. But put it through, get through the essentials, get on to innovation, and make it great. Okay, thank you.
Thank you. Thank you, sir. But lastly, I just wanted to leave you with this thought. I got this opportunity to meet Dr. APJ Abdul Kalam. He was in our office a couple of months back. And the last thing that he said while he closed his speech was, "We must all think big. Thinking small is a crime." So I will leave you with that thought. And again, thank you very much for attending this, and thank you to the panel members as well. Thank you very much.
Thank you so much, all the panel members, as well as the moderator. The discussion concludes saying the technology didn't take away the human element. Although the essential part of the HR function might be taken by the technology, but the unessential part where more work can be enhanced, the human element is still carrying it. Thank you all.
I now invite Professor P. Subramaniam to give a vote of thanks to panel members.
Yeah, good evening, every one of you. How do we thank the industry? There is no easy or simple way. You may not be knowing that every one of them who is kind enough to come all the way to the institute to interact with every one of you has got so much of workload. You may not be knowing, tomorrow when you join the companies, you will come to know. They are all extremely busy people. Even to meet any one of them is a tough task. But they have come all the way to MIT to interact with you. Let us give them a standing ovation. Yeah, please come. This is the only way we can show our respect. Yeah, please, take your seat. On behalf of the entire management, and all of you, my colleagues, my faculties, everyone, I once again formally thank each and every one of them to